Item number, SCP-388. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-388 is to be kept in a locked safe in a room guarded by at least two armed guards, instructed to refuse access to any unauthorized personnel. Use of lethal force is permitted to this end. Unless undergoing experimentation, SCP-388 is to remain outside the influence of any other SCPs demonstrating properties capable of modifying physical laws or drawing energy from unknown sources. Description: SCP-388 consists of a foldable nylon frisbee of the type commonly given away as promotional material, in this case, bearing the logo of the banana boat Suntan Lotion Corporation. SCP-388 appears to be immune to damage. During testing, it has been able to withstand high-caliber rifle shots, immersion in high-acidity baths, and sustained temperatures of 3,500 degrees Celsius. In all cases, it would spring back, unharmed, to its original shape. X-ray crystallography reveals the molecular structure of SCP-388 to be completely normal nylon, supported by a ring of metal appearing to be aluminum. SCP-388 was discovered after witnesses in a local news report in the town of claimed a power line was downed by a UFO. Agents embedded with maintenance crews investigated and found the concrete pole was sliced cleanly, with no tool marks, prompting full investigation status. Aerial records obtained from NORAD revealed no abnormalities, as data expunged, typically associated with data expunged. The investigation was nearly terminated until agents posing as reporters interviewed the family, originally questioned in the news report, and their child mentioned the entire incident as being caused by a frisbee. Initially skeptical, efforts were nonetheless taken to verify this claim, with initial confirmation made on data expunged. A full week of helicopter searches of a neighboring city and numerous retrievals of unremarkable frisbees from rooftops eventually yielded results. Unfortunately, Agent was fatally dismembered by SCP-388 when Agent threw the object down from the roof. Under the guise of replacing a septic tank, SCP-388 was dug up from its resting place 5.5 meters below the yard and carefully brought in for containment. SCP-388, when thrown by a human, appears to travel as a normal frisbee would for a distance of approximately 3 meters. After this distance, SCP-388 immediately begins glowing bright white and accelerates until its velocity reaches approximately meters per second. SCP-388 will proceed to cleanly slice through all intervening matter, regardless of consistency, until eventually coming to rest. Current theory holds that it loses speed due to friction between its top and bottom surfaces and the weight of material pressing down on it as it passes through objects. SCP-388 does not differentiate between matter and test subjects assigned to catch it. Addendum: inquiries into the potential use of SCP-388 as a weapon have been declined in light of the obvious difficulty of retrieving it after its first throw. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-387, Living Lego, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.